Hi everyone, this is Nick and I'm jumping on today to answer a viewer question. One of my favorite viewer questions comes from my sister, Kate, who is a nurse in quality control and she deals a lot in Excel spreadsheets and databases. And sometimes she sends me a question that I don't really know I have the answer to, but then I have to figure it out. So this is obviously not nursing data. This is just fake data that you see here. But her problem was that she was getting an export where there were multiple of the same items in a single cell. And she wanted to know if we could remove the duplicates from that single cell list so that it would show like this. So this column here in B, that would be the export. You can see like even in this row number one, we have orange, blueberry, another orange, and then the strawberry. She wanted to know if there was an easy way that we could remove one of those oranges and do that for the entire group of rows here in each of those cells so that they would look like this in column C. So each row would just list one item one time, but still continue to keep that sort of comma separated list. So I thought of kind of a big workaround, and if anyone's watching this video and you know an easier way, I think it would be great if you would share that as well. I think that there's some ways that we could probably do this working with the VBA code in the back end, but I definitely didn't want to do that. That's beyond my skill level and probably beyond yours, but maybe not. So if you can do that, that would be an awesome way to do it too. But I'm gonna show you a way that I thought through this, and it's gonna involve several of the newer Excel functions if you have Microsoft 365. So I'm going to take you through this sort of step by step, and I'm going to zoom in. Hopefully this is big enough so that you can see some of those functions here. But the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete this. This was my example here. So what I first thought we needed to do is we need to split up all of these cells. Now in the old days, you could go to the data tab and then go to text to columns, but now we have a new function in Excel called text split. And so what that will do is that will split up all of the entries in a single cell based on a common delimiter. And so in this case, that delimiter is the column. So I could tell Excel to split up every single item that is separated by a comma in this one column into several columns. So let's go ahead and do that in this column right here. So I'm going to say type equal, and it's going to be text split. We're going to open the parentheses, and I'm going to point to the text that I want to split up. We're going to do a comma and then open quote, comma, close quote, comma. And that tells Excel that anything that's separated by a comma will be put into different columns in this. And I'm just going to go ahead and close the parentheses. We don't need any of those extra pieces of information there. So once I do this, you will see that it sort of split this up into those four columns there. So all I have to do to do that, all I have to do to make sure that applies to the rest of the data is we're just going to drag this down and copy the formula down. Now you can see we have this pretty nice list here of these separated, I'm gonna just move that there, of just all the different separated values here. Now once in a while when you're doing this, Excel will actually take a leading or a trailing space that you might not see in any of these, and it's gonna treat each of those then differently if there's a single space in there that you can't really see. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wrap this in another function called trim, which gets rid of all of the spaces at the front and the back of a cell. So let's just go back up in with your cursor here in C2. I'm gonna go up here and we're gonna say equals trim, and then open the parenthesis and close the parenthesis on the back end. So that's gonna wrap this entire formula in that trim formula, and it will trim all of the items that I have here in this array. Perfect, so I'm gonna do that, and then I'm just gonna copy down again to make sure those are all copied down there. Now what we need to do, we don't need to have this array formula anymore. An array formula sort of spills over into the other cells. So my actual formula lives in C2, but if I go over, you can see that you still see that trim formula, that text split formula up top, that function, but it's grayed out. So there's not actually any data in these cells. So what we wanna do is we wanna copy this whole range and then paste it back as values so that we have all of the individual values there. So I'm just gonna shift over, tab all the way down. I'm going to push Control C to copy, and then I'm going to right click and paste as values. And we can just click on this little icon right here that's paste options as values. And I'm going to push escape to get rid of the highlighted range there. And now you can see if I tab over, there's no more formulas here. It's all just those individual items. Okay, so this is the first part of our process now. Okay, now the next process is we need to figure out a way to get all of the unique values into header column, into our header row up here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a couple different functions here. So the first one is gonna be the unique function. Unique is a function in Excel that will spit out a list of all unique values from a longer list. So we could do it in a block like this. But we also have to wrap this in a function so that it will just spit out the unique values in a single row, and that's called toRow, T-O-R-O-W. That's that function there. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna equal, and then I'm gonna say unique, and then I'm gonna open the parenthesis, and now I'm gonna do toCol. Actually, we're gonna do toRow. I want it to be in the row, not the column. And then we're going to highlight the array of values. That tells Excel where do I want to look for all of these unique values. And then I'm going to say a one here, I'm going to say ignore blanks. So we're going to ignore those blanks. I'm going to close that parenthesis, and then I'm going to put another comma here, and then I'm going to type in the value true. And that just says that I want it to look, the formula to look by column. So now we're just going to close the parenthesis there. And I think that's all. Let's see, if I push enter, it's going to give me tell me if I did it correctly. And actually, I want to make sure that's the row or the series that we're doing it. I'm going to push enter. And now you see we have all of the unique values just one by one in this nice row here. It doesn't look like any of the values are duplicated or copied. Perfect. Now the other thing I might want to do is sort this A to Z. So let's just go ahead in C1 right here. We're going to wrap this whole formula in a sort function. So we're going to say sort, open the parenthesis, and then close the parenthesis down here. And I think actually what we might actually need to do is we need to do comma over, do a comma, comma, and then we're just going to say true. We're going to sort by column and then close the parenthesis there. Now everything is sorted. Apple, banana, blueberry, grape, guava, mango, orange. All of the unique values are right there. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy this and paste special as values. So now we don't have those formulas anymore. Now what I can do is delete all of that text split data. And now we're going to refer to one of the other videos that we made a while ago about how to analyze select all that apply data when your data come in this sort of format of a comma separated list in a single cell. So now what I need to do is do an if formula and a count if formula. Okay, so we're going to go equals. I'm going to say if, I'm going to say count if, and then I'm going to look at this range right here, and I'm going to put a dollar sign there because I'm going to eventually drag this formula over and across. So this is an absolute row reference right there. And then what we're going to do is we want to say the criteria. Now this is where it gets a little tricky. We have to put these wildcard separators here since there's not a single value in this cell, there's multiple values. So what we're going to do is open quote and then put an asterisk, close quote, then an ampersand sign, that and sign. And then I'm going to point to this header column right here. So anytime you see a value that is Apple in this cell here, it's going to spit out a value that we designate. So I first have to do this. I'm also going to put a dollar sign after that. That's going to be the absolute reference to that specific row and column. And then here we're going to do another ampersand sign, open quote, asterisk the wildcard, close that quote, and then we're going to go ahead and close that. Now we're back to our if function. So I'm going to put a comma here. If there is an apple here, I want it to spit out the value that's in C1. So I'm going to go ahead and just click C1 right there. We're going to put another dollar sign after the C. And then if it's false, it's just going to split out blank. So I'm just going to do open quote, close quote with no space there. Close the parenthesis. And then we get nothing there because there's no apple. But if I drag this down, we'll see if it works. Drag that formula down, and yes, now all of the cells that include the word apple will be spit out in this cell, just apple. Now I'm gonna go ahead and highlight this column, and then I'm gonna drag it over. And now you can see that we have all of the cells here show you where there is one of those values that appears in that cell. Now all we need to do is we need to concatenate all of these in every single row. But we can do this, we could do this with in the old days with a concatenate formula, but we can also do it with the text join formula. That text join formula, or the function text join, will put everything in multiple columns together as we specify. So let's go over here to this column over here. And I'm just going to type equals. Let's move this out just a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and type equals text join. And then the delimiter, how do I want it to show up in this cell? I want it to be a comma and a space. So what I'm going to say is open the quote. I'm going to put a comma and then push the space bar. So there's that little space there. Close the quote. And now I'm going to put another comma. We're going to say ignore empty cells. And now it's asking me, what do I want this to join together? And so I'm going to point to all of my columns here, all of the individual columns that I have right here. Now I'm going to close my parentheses. And now you can see over here in this column, M right here, we have a single list that's concatenated together. All of the duplicates from that single cell are removed. And now I can just drag this formula down, and we have this beautiful column here of values that are separated in the cell, single cell, but all of the duplicate values have been removed. And so now if you wanted to just create and insert a new column right here, and if you wanted to put in your new values, I would just go ahead over here, copy this, Control C, and we'll go ahead and paste this in here. And now these are the values, and that's your list that you have. If you wanted to just override this, and you could, in the output column here, you could put that there, but it's always probably a good idea to keep your data sort of safe. But this is how it's been transformed, and you can do some spot checks to make sure that everything is correct. But I think that was a pretty, fairly simple way, once you just know a few of these formulas, to sort of remove duplicates from a single cell. So Kate, I'm glad you had that question for me. I hope everyone watching this learned a little something new from this. And again, if you have an easier way to do this, I would love to know it. Post it in the comments, make a video tutorial, make a blog post, and share it with everybody. I hope you all have a wonderful day. I had a great time making this video for you. I hope you hit that subscribe button, hit the bell next to it every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. You'll get notified every time that drops. I'll see you all next time.